It is almost that time of year, but holiday makers are struggling to get into the spirit as airfares soar, with some domestic flights costing as much as $1,000. That is just for a one-way ticket.
How crazy. It is pricey, I know. So are there still ways that we can get you home for the holidays? Lonely Planet's Chris Zaya, if he doesn't know, nobody does. He joins us from Melbourne. Good morning, Chris. The airlines, they're being a bit grinchy. What's going on?
Yeah, bah humbug.
Yeah. Yeah, look, it's traditionally we do see a spike in prices in December, and yeah, so it's really quite interesting to see that all of a sudden we're seeing this consistently high pricing running into the month of December. However, there are some tricks to actually get you.
It's like only 35 days until Christmas, Chris. So if you haven't booked the flights early, is it too late? Are there still some great deals that we can nab?
Yeah, look, booking early is always recommended. We are hearing that there are some Black Friday sales that are actually coming up in the not-too-distant future. A lot of us have got a lot of flight credits that are actually available as well, so this is a really good time to be using your flight credits. Potentially consider all the carriers, so actually checking places like Qantas and Jetstar, Virgin Australia and Rex, and making sure that you've got all of those boxes ticked. And then also subscribing to airlines newsletters. So often you'll see the deals come out via the newsletters first.
Ah, okay. All right. So keep an eye on the newsletter. Okay. I usually just delete those ones, but I should actually correct them. No, I know. Yeah. You mentioned there for frequent flyers in particular to use their flight credits. That's what I've done over the Christmas period to book my flights. But they're like hen's teeth, those rewards flights. They're really hard to get.
Mm. Yeah, there are. And also we actually have already spent or potentially have flight credits from flights that were cancelled previously. So that's a really good one there. That's money that you've actually already spent. So these are the things to go in and actually sort of say, actually, I have that you know, $300-$500 credit. I can use that or put that towards put that towards that Christmas flight. There are other things, you know, flying is not the only option, right? So there are other ways to actually get around the country. So maybe considering that drive holiday, carpooling is really a good option because it can save you in terms of petrol costs and in terms of like sharing the drive times. There is good train connectivity between regional centres and between capital cities, so jumping on the train might be another option as well. Or there is really, really good flight prices in middle of January. So actually consider travelling for maybe the Australian Open, or actually just changing the timing that you're going to travel.
Okay, so thinking outside of the box, or you know, different travel options.
Or, I like or walk.
Just start walking
yeah,
now.
Something free.
Much.
Leave yesterday.
No.
But you know, Chris, it's not just domestic flights. International airfares are also through the roof. So when are we going to start to see them come down?
Yeah, we really have to kind of adjust our expectation around both of our budgets and just the way the travel industry is recovering post the pandemic. There's less flights in the air as there was previously. The demand is actually really high, and we still have traditional markets that are closed, which would be bringing lots of capacity into the country. So China being closed at the moment is causing us huge problems because we don't have a lot of aircraft coming in and out of the country. So it's going to take another 18 months to 2 years to recover, unfortunately, as we start to see those things change. But yeah, it's about adjusting our expectations and actually adjusting our budgets, unfortunately.
Mm, okay, so it sounds like another Christmas dinner with FaceTime fired up on the table, you know.
Thank goodness for FaceTime.
Dial the family in remotely. Good on you, Chris. Thank you very much. Nice
Thanks,
to
guys.
See you.